Hey guys, my name is Anurag Sharma. I've just completed my PHP certification course from NIT Dharamshala under the mentorship of Rohit sir, who has helped me and encouraged me a lot throughout this course. Today I'll be telling you about my project and its homestay, which I completed using PHP, a server-side scripting language. So what is a server-side scripting language? A server-side scripting language is this language which runs a code in the backend and interacts with the server at the same time. Unlike the client-side languages like JavaScript, HTML, although I've used a lot of JavaScript and HTML in my project just to increase the dynamic aptitude of my web application. So moving on towards my web application that I made on PHP with the help of my faculty members and from NIT Dharamshala. So now, as you can see, that here's a big code of doctype HTML, which already suggests that it is an HTML file. The code is written in HTML, but I've saved it in PHP to increase the readability in PHP, because I have to ultimately use the PHP commands and another page of sign in where the database is being checked. So firstly, I have to create the database, that is database.php, where I have created the database, as you can see here, and use PHP mailer. I've commented a lot of sections because as a programmer, you know that there are things that one has to comment. The comment section basically helps the users or the programmer, other programmers, to read what the programmer has done and what the programmer has gone through to achieve the result. So the server name is localhost, username root, username is root, the basic username, the default username, and it's a global username, everyone can use it. Database, and this is the syntax for the data creation of database here. I've used first name registration, so the first name, last name, and all of the stuff you see in the database is basically coming from the registration form. So this is the registration form. As you can see that, again, like I said, I've created a lot of HTML tags, used a lot of JavaScript and a lot of CSS, because what I need is a client interactive web application. Because ultimately, if I'm not having a client interactive web application, nobody is going to use that web application. Very obvious. So coming to the first page, the project.php, which is going to be my home page. So now what happens at my home page? Like you can see, this is the home page for the project.php, the front page of the project. Now, like I click on home button, it will redirect me to back to the home page. This is the search button. For example, you need to search some locations, like it's a guest house. So if you want to search some locations, the nearby locations or the facilities we provide, one needs a search button. Just, and it works the same way as you can see in the Facebook web applications. But this is the basics design of a web application. So this is the carousel where images will be shown. These are the images. See, they cannot move. And this is the description box of our homestay, our Anil's homestay, home away from home, as you can see. And the reviews button, like, we use reviews on Amazon. So when we use reviews on Amazon, we use to check the feedback. So what if you want to check the feedback, you can go for the feedback form or check reviews. And this is a photo image where I have used again a lot of JavaScript and CSS, because like I said, I want my client to be able to interact with the web. If he can't interact with the web, ultimately it's of no use. Now, because I'm a little low on network right now, and I haven't provided, and to be very honest, I haven't provided this laptop of mine, the secure the APIs of the APIs of location because of security issues. I'm very, you can say, security sort of person. I don't want anyone to mess up with my security. So I went allowed my Google applications to access my location server. So this is the where I have encoded the place to get the JavaScript for location. You can directly use the Google APIs for that. I've done the same way. And now what is this sign in button? Sign in, as you can see that as I click on sign in button, modal window will open. Modal window does nothing but checks if the user is already registered in the database or not. For example, the Facebook or Instagram account, when you use the web application, you have to check if I am there or not. If it is not there, it will say that you are not present with us, you are not registered with us, and if you are there, you will be redirected to the sign out page. Now you can see here book us and register. For example, when you have to book a hotel or homestay, you will use the book us button. But firstly, you will be asked to register with us. So here I go with the register button. So this is the registration form. As you can see, I've used placeholder tags, and for all of these, this is the date of birth using JavaScript and HTML, all of the same. And this is HTML radio buttons. There I can write my, it is the cache memory I'm using on sessions that I'm using because I've already made an account here. So you can see that only clicking on one thing can give fill the rest of it. So I just messed up. 0508 1996, that's my date of birth. And now coming to the main part, password and confirm password, which is a very important part nowadays as there is a massive increase in the amount of bots. So what happens here? Let us take it very simple. Qwerty. See, the password is not matching here. As the password is not matching here, you can see that it displays a red message saying not matching. Now Qwerty, it displays a green message saying yes, the password is matching. How I achieved it? What was the main purpose to achieve it, and how did I do it? Here is our registration form. Now you can see here that I've used script, like I said, JavaScript. I've used a lot of JavaScript. You have to increase the dynamic aptitude of a website, because ultimately it's the user interaction client wants. Client doesn't want the way it was back in 1990. He or she wants to be in present, to go forward, to reduce workload on himself. So this is a Java code, JavaScript code to be exact, JavaScript code that I've used to achieve the same what I showed you just now, the green message and the red messages. Now this is the database, and this is the sign out button which will be used, and the sign button which will be used time and again to check whether the registration has been completed or the user is already registered. Now coming back to the page, now you can see that I've entered my address. Now as the address is entered, now because I already told you that I'm already registered here, so here comes the message: user already exists, please try signing in. Because I'm a registered member, I can't re-register myself. Have you ever tried re-registering yourself in Facebook? A same type of dialog box comes up. Now I'll try signing in. Now I will give it my email ID and my password with which I registered. And here I am to the sign out page where I'll be asked to sign out and not sign in. Now I can book here anything. I can't register here at cost, but you can see a registration form again, but it will redirect me here back. And then again, the same user Google APIs, the same footer bars, and JavaScript. And so it's much of a recursive code. But when we use it again and again, and we have to increase the pages, the recursion goes to the amount of negligibility. Now, what's happening at the back end? How is my server being able to know, or how is this page knowing that I'm already there? Like I told you, register button, the registration.php, the database.php knows that yes, I'm here or am I not. Now getting back to it, now we have completed registration, we have completed database.php. Now we are going to see what sign in does. Like I told you, sign in is just checking the value if I am there or not. So this was all in the project. It was a very basic web application. I would like to thank the faculty members and my mentor who helped me a lot throughout this project and encouraged my R&D, and I know it's going to help me a lot when I'm going to apply for some big companies. Thank you. Thank you, Anurag Sharma.